a gentleman should remove his hat in the presence of a lady, Parker?
I never take off my hat except when I'm out of doors.
Is she as lovely as your sister was, Basil?
Yes. But I'm afraid Dorian has stolen her heart from me, too.
I must congratulate you, Basil. Look at yourself, Mr. Gray.
This picture will remain always young. If it were only the other way, if it were I who was always to be young, and the picture that was to grow old.
You would hardly care for such an arrangement, Basil. It would be rather hard lines on your work.
I should object strongly, Harry.
You wouldn't express such a wish in the presence of that cat, Dorian. It's one of the 73 great gods of Egypt, and is quite capable of granting your wish.
Lord Henry is right. I know now that when one loses one's youth, one loses everything.
Perhaps a cup of tea will bring you round, Dorian. You will have some too, won't you, Harry? Or do you object to such simple pleasures?
I adore simple pleasures. They're the last refuge of the complex.
It's more than a painting. It's part of myself.
As soon as you're varnished and framed, Dorian, you will be sent home. Then you can do whatever you like with yourself.
You better send along the Egyptian cat. I don't think the god and the picture should be separated.
I will if Dorian wants it.
If only the picture could change, and I could be always what I am now. For that, I would give everything. Yes, there's nothing in the whole world I would not give. I would give my soul for that.